Here we have this list of NBA players. In the upper right corner of each player, we have this button. When we click this button, we want to open a modal to display more information about the specific player. This is something that is fairly easy to do with the CDK overlay module. But before we can use it, we first need to install it, which we can do with this command within our Angular app. After we have it installed, we will want to include the overlay pre-built CSS file from the library. I normally include this in something like the global styles, so let's import it here. Okay, now we're ready to wire up our modal. The first thing we need to do is inject the overlay service into our constructor so that we can use it. Now let's create an open modal method that will call on click of our button. Within this method, first we'll create our overlay using the create method from the service. Let's add const overlay ref, since that's what we'll have after calling create. We'll set this equal to this.overlay, and we'll call the create method. Now we need to attach some markup to the overlay. So we'll use our overlay ref, and we'll call the attach method. This method has a parameter where we need to pass a CDK template portal. Before we can add this portal, we first need to import the portal module. Okay, so now we can switch over to our template. We'll add an ng template. On this template, we'll add the CDK portal directive. And within this template, let's add our player details component. This component has an input where it takes in a player object, so we'll pass it our current player. Now, we also need to import this player component, so let's do that real quick. Okay, the next thing we need to do is access the portal that we just added in the template, so we can pass it to our attach method. So we add at viewchild and make sure it gets imported. For this, its selector will be the CDK portal. We'll call this property portal and we'll type it to CDK portal as well. Now that we have a handle to the portal, we can simply add it to our attach method. And the last thing we need to do is call this open modal method when the button is clicked. So in our template, on the button, we bind to the click event, and then we call our method. And there it is. The click opens the modal with our player details. So this is pretty cool. If we inspect the modal, we can see that the markup for our player details is actually getting injected to a container here at the end of the body. This is pretty crazy since our player component is up here within the app component.